know no color. They don't know no political group. Now, that being said, it was made by people of color.
Yeah.
But the fact of the matter is that we make music, but we don't run the business. I'll just put it like that.
Okay, I agree. Now, Joe, you hit it right on the head. that we the product, but we don't own the product.
Exactly.
All right, talk about your Hornet's Nest. How is it doing for you?
Hornet's Nest is doing pretty good, actually. You know, people like it all over the world. It's made the best list of some of the magazines, radio stations. But, we were just talking about America, and it's pretty hard. You know, things are pretty hard right now. Just not for Joe Louis, but for a lot of people.
Right.
You know, why pay for something when you can get it for free? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, it's sort of, you just got to keep doing it because you love it. And, you know, hope that you break luck, you know?
Right. And, you know, one of my favorites on that Hornet Nest, I like the CD. It's a good CD. I like the When the Sun Goes Down, As the Sun Goes Down. And maybe because I'm in Chicago, so I don't know if that has anything to do with it. But, it, you know, I'm a Mississippi boy, but I like the soulfulness of the song, you know.
Well, just like B.B. King say, Chicago blues ain't nothing but a bunch of guys in Mississippi who moved to Chicago, you know.
That's exactly right, you know.
Well, Black Girl was a song that me and my songwriter partner, JoJo Russo, wrote. And JoJo, when we write, we don't worry about politically correct. I mean, it's just a fan from the heart.
Right.
Yeah, and Joe, me, I grew up half a block in the Field Auditorium. So I got to see Argentina turn a little bit. You get the Temptations, real Temptations with Dave Ruffy, James Brown before he got a new bag, and all that, you know. JoJo didn't get to see that. Him being a white boy, although he was raised by a Black man, he was in Pittsburgh, California, and I was right there in San Francisco, right across. I went to junior high school half a block away. So I used to get into the auditorium free. We had our bows at the band. So he asked me, he said, man, what do you miss? You know, it's about 4 or 5 years ago. And I said, I miss them reviews. I can King of Turner review. They had the Bad Dog, the Englishman. They had the girl groups. They had the gospel girl groups. And in some kind of way that got lost. They made a movie about it called 20 Feet from Stardom. You know, and without those ladies on their music, it would have been different music all along the board. I mean, everybody from, you know, you listen to Aretha Franklin and her cousin singing, and Sister Carolyn Franklin, and you listen to the staple singers, listen to all that. They didn't only sing with each other. They backed up a lot of other people, too.
Right.
A whole lot of, Whitney Houston's mama sang behind Elvis Presley for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And they called them Sweet Inspiration. They had a hit called Sweet Inspiration. And so, you know, there was all that going on. But JoJo missed it. And so he said, you know, he listens to the rock and roll today. And it just sounded like, you know, people trying to sound like Black Girl.
Mm-hmm.
So he just said, you know, forget it. I'm going to write a song called Black Girl. And so we wrote